SIMC UG's News Bulletin, First Break. I am Amla Ashraf Kumar.
And I am Janvi Asthana.
On the News Bulletin today, we have our campus talent, SIMC Dance Crew, who represent our college in almost every festival. Malhar, the St. Xavier College Festival, or Simbhav, the Symbiosis Law School's Fest, to name a few. The crew mainly comprises of students from the batch of 2014 and 2015. We have Sanjana Verma covering the story.
Here's Urvashi Atavle and Unni Krishnan Nair representing SIMC crew.
How did the crew start?
The crew actually, both of us were into dance and we started with meeting people in the batch, and he's from the first year, I'm from the second year, but we performed for Malhar, so we knew each other, and that's how we met people who were interested in dance, and we started having practices and started going out for practices, and that's how we went to competition.
SIMC, our crew as a whole, we went to three major college fests. One was at SIT Lavale, the other one was at Cummins Engineering College for girls, and the third one was Simbha, the fest which is organized by SLS.
What does dance mean for your crew?
I think
that is a question which varies for each and everyone, but dance basically is just making yourself feel good. In a college like this, where you barely have time for yourself, it's one resort that makes you feel good, makes you feel good about who you are. That's a time for yourself.
Similarly, I mean, the day is very hectic, and that one time when you can live your own life the way you want, just through dance, through different styles of dance. It's basically life for us.
It's a way of expression.
What are your future plans?
We have in fact already started with practicing every day, other than the dance club or anything. We meet every day and you know, just choreograph as many songs, steps, styles, refining steps. And as you know, as a group, we want to basically just get that finish in our dance. So that's what we are meeting every day, and for an hour or so after college, whenever we can. It's not a compulsion, but whenever we can, we meet up, we dance, and just try and make it as perfect as possible.
The Symbiosis Girls Hall of Residence has undergone a new development, the closure of the Mada hostel gate, a doorway to many daily amenities like shops and bus stands. This action has led to various reactions. We have Gargi Verma covering the story.
Here is one of the hostelites, Shreya Sharma, and let's know her views. What do you think about the closure of the Mada gate?
I think it's the security measure that could be taken, but I think it's just going beyond the, you know, the use of it, because they should really open it for a while in the daytime because the risk is minimal that time. Mm-hmm. And closing it from the morning to the evening doesn't make a lot of sense, because people need to go out and take the bus, and it doesn't make sense to go all the way around to take the bus. So I think it should be a little, you know, more of control.
Let's ask the guard bhaiyas what was the real reason. भैया ये गेट क्यों बंद किया?
गेट मैडम ऐसे बाहर प्रॉब्लम हो गया था, एक बच्चे का स्टूडेंट को मारा था, इसलिए बड़ा सर ने बंद किया।
सो यू सी सिक्योरिटी इज रियली एन इशू। लेट्स आस्क दिव्या अनदर हॉस्टलाइट व्हाट शी फील्स अबाउट इट।
वेल व्हाट आई फील अबाउट महारा गेट बीइंग क्लोज इज एक्चुअली गुड, बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली इफ यू आर द स्टूडेंट्स डोंट हैव द इंटेंशन ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग देयर बॉयफ्रेंड्स ओवर हियर, बट द मेंटालिटी ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ महारा इज नॉट एज मच developed or like too much not modern as concerned with us. So the people who actually bring their boyfriends or brothers, they have to be much more cautious and because they made some mistakes, the problems arose. And it's better right now that it's being closed.
Here is Nisha ma'am, the warden. Let's ask her why was this gate closed.
Probably हमने जो बंद किया है सिर्फ स्टूडेंट की सिक्योरिटी के लिए. यहाँ जो बाहर 3 साल से जो इंसिडेंट हो रहे हैं बच्चों को पत्थर मारना लाठी से मारना एक लड़की को 2 साल तक जो हुआ था कि लोहे से उसको मारा अभी ज़्यादा इंसिडेंट्स हो गए हैं 8 से 10 बजे के बीच में और ख़ासतौर रेडी के रोड पर अंदर भी हुए छोटे मोटे पत्थर मारते हैं ड्रंकर जो है लड़की के पीछे आते जाते हैं उनका आर्गूमेंट सुनने पड़ते हैं क्रिकेट खेलते हैं तो जानबूझकर बच्चों को पत्थर मारते हैं और ख़ास तौर पर ये है जो हमारे जो बाजू में है इसको ख़ास तौर पर प्रॉब्लम है कि इस्लाम एरिया है और मैं मुझे ऐसे लगता है कि शायद सोसाइटी का गैप ही है कि इनके पास इतना सब कुछ है और हमारे पास कुछ नहीं ये भी हो सकता है इनकी इंटेंसिटी ठीक नहीं है और बच्चों की सिक्योरिटी के लिए खास हमने वो बंद कर रखा है
Symbiosis Girls Hostel, home to many students, has a major issue in hand to be resolved. All the questions from the students to the authority will be put into focus in this episode.
So as we know, there have been major changes in the hostel rules, like 6 night outs per month, AC is being taken out, and 9:30 to 10:30 signing time. What, according to you, can be the possible reason for bringing about such changes?
Firstly, the 6 night outs. We feel that any student going out, taking out the night out for 6 times in a month is sufficient because you are basically here for studies and 6 times in a month if you go out, that should meet the requirement of your enjoyment, or you can say entertainment or relaxation, whatever you can think. And as far as the timing with 9:30 to 10:30 is concerned, some students are requesting after signing the attendance or marking the attendance, they want to go out for half an hour, 45 minutes. So, you will agree with me, once you sign the attendance, it is not correct to go out. If anything happens to you, we cannot justify why you are out of the hostel. So if you want to go to the hostel, you are permitted to come at 10 o'clock. But you can't have the cake and eat it like that. You sign the attendance also at 8:30 and go again. Suppose you don't come out, or you don't, you meet with an accident. What happens? Last thing is about ACs removal. Pune is a place which has got a good climate and ACs are not required per se. We don't want to create any kind of class distinction between students. Some students think that since the students who are staying in ACs are rich and all that they can afford, there's quite a jealousy factor comes. And also some students are irresponsible, they who got AC rooms and all that, they don't switch off the ACs when they're not in the room. Which is actually causing national wastage of electricity. And also, ACs running continuously also will increase the temperature outside also. And some students who don't pay AC charges, they go and sleep in the rooms of the students who got ACs. So that also is a kind of indiscipline. In a hostel, all students must have same kind of facility. That's the basic reason. The management has taken a decision not to continue the AC facility from this year onwards.
Was the decision of implementing the rules was taken by you or taken by the higher authority?
All the decisions have been taken by the Symbiosis Mohanagar Coordination Committee, the Campus Coordination Committee, which comprises of the directors of the institutes as well as the campus administrator. And additionally, removal of ACs is taken at the highest level.
Movies are an important part of media having the maximum reach. So SIMC UG decided to celebrate the centenary of films in India. The Film Day, a unique concept by the AV Club, was celebrated on the 5th of March. Everyone was expected to dress up as their favorite characters. The entire college looked like a fairground with characters ranging from Barfi to Rekha to Bellatrix and even G.I. Joes. The supervillains like Bane, Joker and Gabbar Singh made their presence felt. We, at first break, decided to take a peep into these characters.
begin.
Hi, my name is Soham and I'm dressed up as Bain. There's no good reason behind me becoming Bain just because I'm bald. I thought Bane would be damn cool, damn killer to be for the film day. So yeah, that's it.
It's Disco Diwali.
Hi, I'm Ranjini, and I imagine Bollywood as the old late 60s, how the actresses used to be dressed as.
Hello, I am dressed as Charlie Chaplin's tramp simply because I have been an inspiration for a lot of directors across the world. You can also observe me in Raj Kapoor's movies. It is because slapstick as a genre, especially in comedy, was very specific and well known across the world. And even today people enjoy my humor, don't you?
Hi, I'm Aishwarya and I'm dressed up as Rekha, and my inspiration is that I think Rekha she's like the epitome of beauty in spite of all odds inside her, and that's what inspires me. That's why I'm dressed up as Rekha today.
Pune City recently witnessed a slightly out of league event. It was a boat festival by College of Engineering Pune. First of its kind, it did manage to create interest. It was a report covered by Poonima Kohli.
College of Engineering Pune is among the few colleges in the world which hosts an annual regatta organized by the Boat Club Pune. Regatta literally means a series of boat races. Since its inception in 1928, it has showcased around 165 boats, notably the Aether, which is one of the oldest boats. The 85th edition of regatta was held on 10th March 2013. It is the magnificent outcome of rigorous practice, perceptive minds, devotion, and intense determination. The regatta exhibits the perseverance and talent of the students who practice day and night to entertain an audience of over 8,000 people coming from far corners of the city with their splendid displays of the boats. The boats are decorated with multicolored LED lights, which are wisely used as per the act of different splendid formations they showcase to the audience. The whole show is very well coordinated among all the students. Across the globe, it is exemplified in the form of 63 international and 319 national events. Over the years, the prestigious tradition of the glorious boating show has redefined and refined the term regatta. With every passing year, the rejuvenated version of regatta scales new heights of innovation and expertise in multiple events.
Next on the board, we have Viswak Sen covering the biggest battle amongst the batches in True Spirits. The only time when all the three batches gear up for an event which either makes their batch or breaks it. The only time when the academics take the back seat and sports is all that matters.
True Spirits Volleyball 2013 turned out to be a spectacular success, with 2014 running out the eventual winners. The 2014 team were widely regarded as favorites and lived up to their billing. Whereas the 2015 team seemed severely ill-prepared and were made to pay the price on the pitch. Although the 2015 team put in a great deal of effort throughout the match, it just wasn't happening for them. It was an exciting match with great displays of skill from both sides, and in the end, the better team emerged the victor.
So I have
stuck with me is the captain of the winning team from 2014. They just came to the 2015 team. Good game. I shouted my voice hoarse throughout the game, but 2015 fought well. We were just the better team.
Concludes our coverage of Intro Spirits Volleyball. Most of the players are too excited and still too pumped with adrenaline to talk to us coherently right now. We'll meet you again at the next event, which is basketball tomorrow morning.
A fest that unites all the three batches and initiates interaction. A fest in which all the three batches come on to celebrate. Vaivedya is a collage of good song, dance and drama. The theme for this year was 100 years of Indian cinema. We have with us Nandita Kalidas taking us through the journey.